Today I'm going to show you how you can display like data from database in tables within table form on your website. And as you see here, this is just the website we are continuing from the last which I finished off. And let's log in. As you see, I'm logged in, and this is the page where I showed you how to create user messaging on your website. And now let's go and create tables, how you can add tables and display data and then search through those tables. So let's go into dashboard and I will open it in new link, and I will open it in new link, and let's go to plugins and let's go to add new. Then we go into search, and in search we will type in table press, it's one word, table press. Okay, let's wait a little bit and you will see this very first plugin, and it says embed beautiful and future rich tables into your posts and pages without having to write code. So I will show you how to do it, and let's install it first, because as you know guys, we need to install plugin and activate plugin, and this is what we are going to do first. And then I will show you how to insert data, how to add tables like rows, columns and other things, and data into those rows and columns, and how to display it on your page. And as you see guys, now we have installed and activated this plugin table press, and now we have here on the left hand side front actually this was one another one this is table press, as you see here. And here let's click in into table press, and you will see here tabs on top, and you will see them underneath this all tables, add new table, import table, export table. And actually this plugin allows you to import tables if you have in CSV or Excel file tables. Like, let's go straight away, I will show you. Into import table, you see that we can import tables like from URL, we can import tables from file, like we choose file, from CSV file as you see, from Excel file, and from different other files as you see, from JSON and so on and so forth. You can import it and it will automatically create a table for you. You will not even have to create it yourself. And this is a good option for you to play around. And this is export table, and this option, if you have tables, allows you to export these tables into CSV file or in other formats, guys. And next thing what we do is let's go to all tables, and as you see here we don't have tables yet. And to import, to add table to some page, we will need to create some page, we will need to install or add or copy and paste this kind of code into our page. But let's go and create a new table. And to create a new table, first we click add new table, then we give a table name, and I will just say my table. You can give it whatever name you want, and here you can add some description, like some description, for example. It doesn't really matter. And here you can select how many rows and how many columns you want on your table. And it doesn't matter, even if you will leave it now as the default 5 and 5, you can always add after more columns or more tables to your already created tables. So let's leave 5 rows and 5 columns. So rows are those which go horizontally and the columns goes vertically. So and click add table. Okay guys, and here with the list, let's dismiss this one, and this is our table, and this is how it looks like, guys. And here at the very first row you are writing what your column names will be. For example, you can call them however you want, and I will say first, and in second I will add. This could be anything for you, whatever you need. So in first one I will add like one, like for example, in second two and three and four, so you have a good understanding what is going on here. And here I will add some text, like more text, it doesn't really matter, I will add more, like just we'll copy it in and paste in more rows so you can see it. But you can leave them empty, you don't need to enter text in all of them if you don't want, for example, and things like that, guys. Let's leave the last one empty. And yes, if you want you can delete rows just by checking, and here you click delete if you want to, as you see here, delete rows. If you want to delete columns which are vertical, then you check here underneath and you click delete button, or if you would want to insert one more row, for example, then you just click here and add, and it inserted, as you see, one more row. If you want to add more columns, you click here on this side, add, and it added one more column. So this is new call, for example. So this is pretty much easy to play, come and play around. And this, if you want pagination, for example, this tells how many you can add on one page, for example, or how many results you want to display on one page. This is 10. You can add any number, you can add 1000 if you want, and then all your rows or all your table will be on one page and there will be no pagination at all. So, and once you have done this editing, you can play around. This is straightforward, and after you have done everything, you just click this save changes, and saving successful. The table was saved successfully, guys. So next thing what we need to do, like I mentioned, always when you will create this table, you will have this code at the very top. You just will need to copy it, as you see for this one. And now we will need to create a page. As you see, we don't have any pages here, and I will create one more page and I will call it table. Okay, you can call it how you want. So add new page, and I will call this particular page table. And as in my menu, all newly created pages are automatically being added to the top menu. It will appear on the top menu. So, and here in this page content, you just paste in this particular code, table ID 1/, and click publish. Okay, and now let's open this. Open link in new window, and here it is, guys. Here is your table, as you see, and you can search this table, you can do with it whatever you want. For example, if we would search for 4, as you see, it only returns one result because there is only one result with 4, with number 4. If you would want to search for 2, for example, or if there would be more results with 2, once you enter them in search, they automatically get searched in one page, guys. And here you can decide how many results you want to display. And like I mentioned, if you would want more than 10 results on one page without pagination, you can easily add there whenever you are creating table, let's say 1000 to display on one page, or 10,000, or however you need, how many you need, guys. So yes, this is pretty much it for this video. If you liked it, leave a like, share this video, subscribe to my channel, and see you in my other videos.